Kagame's military career from 1979 to 1994, starting with the Ugandan Bush War. In 1978, Fred Rwigema returned to Western Uganda and reunited with Kagame. During his absence, Rwigema had joined the rebel army of Yoweri Museveni. Based in Tanzania, it aimed to overthrow the Ugandan government of Idi Amin. Rwigema returned to Tanzania and fought in the 1979 war, during which Museveni's army allied with the Tanzanian army and other Ugandan exiles defeated Idi Amin. After Amin's defeat, inspired by Rwigema, Kagame and other Rwandan refugees pledged allegiance to Museveni, a cabinet member in the transition government. Kagame received training at the United States Army Command and General Staff College in Fort Leavenworth, Kansas. Former incumbent Milton Obote won the 1980 Ugandan general election. Museveni disputed the result, and he and his followers withdrew from the new government in protest. In 1981, Museveni formed the Rebel National Resistance Army, or NRA. Kagame and Rwigema joined as founding soldiers, along with 38 Ugandans. The army's goal was to overthrow Obote's government in what became known as the Ugandan Bush War. Kagame and Rwigema joined the NRA primarily to ease conditions for Rwandan refugees persecuted by Obote. They also had a long-term goal of returning with other Tutsi refugees to Rwanda, and as well, this military experience would enable them to fight the Hutu-dominated Rwandan army. In the NRA, Kagame specialized in intelligence gathering, and he rose to a position close to Museveni's. The NRA, based in Nuero Triangle, fought the Ugandan army for the next 5 years, even after Obote was deposed in a 1985 coup d'etat and the start of peace talks. In 1986, the NRA captured Kampala with a force of 14,000 soldiers, including 500 Rwandans, and formed a new government. After Museveni's inauguration as a president, he appointed Kagame and Rwigema as senior officers in the new Ugandan army, as Kagame was the head of military intelligence. In addition to the army duties, Kagame and Rwigema began building a covert network of Rwandan Tutsi refugees within the army's ranks, intended as the nucleus for an attack on Rwanda. In 1989, Rwanda's president Habyarimana and many Ugandans in the army began to criticize Museveni over his appointment of Rwandan refugees to senior positions, and he decided to demote Kagame and Rwigema. Kagame and Rwigema remained de facto senior officers, but the change caused them to accelerate their plans to invade Rwanda. They decided to join an organization called the Rwandan Patriotic Front, or RPF, which was a refugee association which had been operating under various names since 1979. Rwigema became RPF's leader shortly after joining, and while still working for the Ugandan army, he and Kagame completed their invasion plans. The second part of Kagame's military career is the Rwandan Civil War, of which in October 1990, Rwigema led a force of over 4,000 RPF rebels into Rwanda at the Kagitumba border post, advancing 60 kilometers or 37 miles south to the town of Gabiro. By that time, Kagame was not present at the initial raids, as he was in the United States attending the Command and General Staff College in Fort Leavenworth. Rijema was killed on the third day of the attack, throwing the RPF into confusion. France and Zaire deployed forces in support of the Rwandan army, and by the end of October, the RPF had been pushed back into the far northeast corner of the country. Kagame returned to Africa and took command of the RPF forces, which had been reduced to fewer than 2,000 troops. Kagame and his soldiers moved west through Uganda to the Virunga Mountains, a rugged high-altitude area where the terrain worked in their favor. And from there, he rearmed and reorganized the army and carried out fundraising and recruitment from the Tutsi diaspora. Kagame restarted combat in January 1991 with an attack on the northern town of Ruhengeri. Benefiting from the elements of surprise, the RPF captured the town and held it for a day before retreating back into the forest. For the next year, the RPF waged a classic hit-and-run guerrilla war, capturing some border areas but not making significant gains against the Rwandan army. Following the June 1992 formation of a multi-party coalition government in Kigali, Kagame announced a ceasefire and initiated negotiations with the Rwandan government in Arusha, Tanzania. In early 1993, groups of extremist Hutu formed and began campaigns of large-scale violence against the Tutsi. And so Kagame responded by suspending peace talks temporarily and launching a major attack, gaining a large swath of land across the north of the country. Peace negotiations resumed in Arusha, and the resulting set of agreements, known as the Arusha Accords, were signed in August 1993. The RPF were given positions in a broad-based transitional government, or BBTG, and in the National Army. The United Nations Assistant Mission for Rwanda, or what we call the UNAMIRA, as a peacekeeping force, arrived, and the RPF were given a base in the National Parliament building in Kigali to use during the establishment of the BBTG. The third and final part of Kagame's military career is the 1994 genocide against the Tutsi in Rwanda. On 6 April 1994, Rwandan President Habyarimana's plane was shot down near Kigali Airport, killing both Habyarimana and the president of Burundi, Cyprien Ntaryamira, as well as their entourage and three French crew members. The attackers remained unknown. Historian Gerard Prunier, in his book written shortly after incident, concluded that it was mostly likely a coup d'etat carried out by extreme Hutu members of Habyarimana's government and was a planned part of the genocide. And so, this theory was disputed in 2006 by French judge Jean Lois and in 2008 by Spanish judge Fernando Andreu. As both alleged that Kagame and the RPF were responsible. Following Habyarimana's death, a military committee led by Colonel Theonest Bagosora took immediate control of the country. Under the committee's direction, the Hutu Militia, Interahamwe, and the Presidential Guard began to kill Hutu and Tutsi opposition politicians and other prominent Tutsi figures. Within 24 hours, they had killed all moderate leaders, including Prime Minister Agathe Uwilingiyimana. These killers then began targeting the entire Tutsi population, as well as moderate Hutu, beginning the Rwandan genocide. Over the course of approximately 100 days, between 500,000 and 1 million Tutsi and politically moderate Hutu were killed in well-planned attacks. On 7th of April, Kagame warned the committee and UNAMIR that he could resume the civil war if the killing did not stop. The next day, the Rwandan government forces attacked the National Parliament building from several directions, but the RPF troops stationed there successfully fought back as Kagame began an attack from the north on three fronts, seeking to link up quickly with the troops isolated in Kigali. As an interim government was set up, but Kagame refused to talk to it, believing that it was just a cover for Bagosora's rule. Over the next few days, the RPF advanced steadily south, capturing Gabiro and large areas of countryside to the north and east of Kigali. They avoided attacking Kigali or Byumba at this stage, but conducted maneuvers designed to encircle the cities and cut off supply routes. The RPF allowed Tutsi refugees from Uganda to settle behind the front line in the RPF-controlled areas. Throughout April, there were numerous attempts by UNAMIR to establish a ceasefire, but Kagame insisted each time that the RPF would not stop fighting unless the killings stopped. In late April, the RPF secured the wall of the Tanzanian border area and began to move west from Kibungo to the south of Kigali. They encountered little resistance except around Kigali and Ruhengeri. By 16th May, they had cut the road between Kigali and Gitarama, the temporary home of the interim government, and by 13th June, they had taken Gitarama following an unsuccessful attempt by the Rwandan government forces to reopen the road. The interim government was forced to relocate to Gisenyi in the far northwest. As well as fighting the war, Kagame was recruiting heavily to expand the army. The new recruits included two survivors of the genocide and refugees from Burundi, but were less well-trained and disciplined than the earlier recruits. Having completed the encirclement of Kigali, Kagame spent the latter half of June fighting to take the city. The government forces had superior manpower and weapons, but the RPF steadily gained territory, as well as conducting raids to rescue civilians from behind enemy lines. According to Romeo Darrera, the force commander of UNAMIR, said that this success was due to Kagame being a master of psychological warfare, as he exploited the fact that the government forces were concentrating on the genocide rather than the fight for Kigali, and capitalized on the government's loss of morale as it lost territory. The RPF finally defeated the Rwandan government forces in Kigali on 4th July, and on 18th July, they took Gisenyi and the rest of the northwest, forcing the interim government into Zaire and ending the genocide. At the end of July 1994, Kagame's forces held the wall of Rwanda except for a zone in the southwest, which had been occupied by a French-led United Nations force as part of Operation